from Shan He Gu Ren or Mountains May Depart, depending which title you want to use. This is a movie from China. It's a love story between a female choreographer for the Olympics. She was in this film part of a dance and song team to promote the Olympics in her country. And she also worked in a small shop selling electronics. This was on the verge of China's embracing of capitalism and runaway capitalism, which followed. And there was two guys pursuing this one girl. One was a hard-working man, worked in a coal mine, till it eventually caused him cancer. He had to go and borrow money from this girl to get a cancer operation, but that was later on, decades later. This follows their lives from 1998, I think, or 99, until maybe they're promoting the New Year. I can't remember now if it was the Olympics or the New Year. The onset of 1990, yeah, it must have been the New Year. And as the film goes, 15 years later, the coal miner didn't end up with this girl. The rich industrialist who actually bought the coal mine told his friend, "I don't want you being around her, seeing her anymore, take a hike." So he fires the guy. The guy goes off to work in another coal mine someplace, and eventually he catches cancer, has to come back 15 years later. He needs money for a cancer operation. His wife tries to take care of that and can't do it. He has a little boy, I think, a little girl. No, he's a little boy. So he's got a lot to live for. He eventually gets the money from this girl that he used to date or used to be friends with. She's now divorced from the industrialist who bought the coal mine. Didn't work out. She has now a child, and he lives with his father. They moved to Australia. They left China to become richer. The father, in this case, the industrialist, he's a complete arsehole. He, totally selfish to the point where he would actually get a gun and shoot any opposition to his wanting to acquire this woman as his wife, which didn't work out anyway. Then we shoot ahead in, I think it was 1999, 2015. Now we shoot ahead to 2024, I think it was, or 27. And we're in Australia. The son has since grown up. He's become his own man. He's breaking away from his father's influence. There's a massive struggle there. His father's a complete nut job. He's got all kinds of weapons and guns. He's living in Australia. You can apparently buy guns at that time, but can't fire them. I don't know if that's the case now, but the son breaks away, forms some type of a romantic bond with his much, much older teacher. She's in her 40s. He's probably 19, 18 years old. And the teacher's trying to convince him to go, go home, go back to China, visit your mother. Go see how she's doing, because you haven't seen her in a long time. But how are you going to introduce our romantic relationship? And this is how the movie ends. The mother, he decides, well, I can't go back. I can't see her again. The romantic relationship with this older woman dies as well at that point. She's just gone through a divorce with her own husband. And the scene ends with the much older woman, the main character in the story. She's just reliving memories of the past, the 1999, whatever it was that they were doing then. I'm not up big on the Olympics, so I don't know if the Olympics were going on at that time. So I'm thinking more or less more towards this celebration was probably towards turning to the year 2000. But yeah, this is an interesting story. Like, it starts off slow. It's like a locomotive. It starts building up. If you understand the Chinese language, you'll enjoy this very much. It does turn English to the English language at the end of the movie. They do speak English. Because, well, they were living in Australia, except for the psychotic father with all the guns. He still speaks Chinese, but he regrets having moved to Australia. He feels so alone at the time. Excellent movie, good storyline, a lot of interesting situations here. And as I said, it starts off extremely slow. It's a fun movie, starts off extremely slow, but then it builds up. It's like a locomotive. It's just running down the tracks to a very, very interesting ending as we view into the lives of all these different characters. You don't see the coal miner doesn't show up in the 2024 ending part. So I suspect he may have died from his cancer, I don't know. But the other characters do show up.